everybody, welcome to Andertons TV. My name is Pete.
And my name is Rabir.
And this is one of our epic shootouts. This is probably the most epic shootout we will ever do.
I think you're probably right there.
Yeah.
This is the biggest shootout of 2016.
This is a massive shootout. Just have a look behind us here. Check that out. Boom.
Just before we get stuck right in, we just want to say that we've picked, to the best of our ability, the most similar or equivalent in each brand, if that makes sense. So 112 combo where we can, some are 210s because there is no 112s, but they're all 112 between 50 and 100 watts is the plan.
It's the plan, and I will be using a Fender Stratocaster for some, and this is, so we didn't want to pick anything really expensive.
No.
Because this is kind of a, you know, low price to mid-priced amplifier, so we thought instead of using Custom Shop this and that, we would use some, you know, fairly priced. This is a Mexican Strat.
Yep.
It's about £500. It's a limited edition one, sparkly, I love it.
And this is the new 2017 PRS SE Custom 24.
Exactly. And the amps that we're going to be doing are not necessarily in this order.
Mm-hmm.
Boss Katana 100.
Mm-hmm.
Marshall Code 50.
Mm-hmm.
Vox
VT100X.
VT100X.
Mm-hmm.
The Fender Mustang 3 Mark II.
Mm-hmm.
The Line 6 Spider 560, and that's got a 10 in it, because unfortunately there isn't available this time in November 2016, there is not a 12 available for us.
Unfortunately not.
The Blackstar ID Core with two 10s in it.
Yep.
And the Blackstar ID60
TVP.
TVP.
Yeah.
And those are the amps that we're going to be shooting out today. So, shall we just get on with it?
I say, without further ado, let's start shooting.
Let's do it. All right then, so here we are with the first amp of the Magnificent Seven.
It is
some
the Magnificent
Seven. Some could say Magnificent Seven.
It's a great name, Pete.
It's a great name for this video.
It is.
And the first one is the Vox Valtronic VT100X.
It is.
Yeah.
So the name gives a bit away. It's 100 watts.
100 watts?
Yes, it is. And the VT stands for Valvetronics.
Valvetronics.
And that basically means that it's got a 12AX7 preamp tube in the circuit, which allows the response to be more authentic. You can do things like change the biasing in real time between hot and cold, like that. So the range consists of three different amplifiers. You've got the VT20X, the 40X, and the 100X. And the only difference between all of them is the size of the speaker and the wattage, of course. So we're playing the biggest one, which has got a 12-inch speaker in it. So there are 13 different effects in the VT series.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so obviously they're modelled on sort of the most famous stompboxes you can imagine, you know, with your reverbs, delays, phasers, choruses,
ranges,
all that kind of stuff.
All that stuff, tremolos, all that stuff.
Yeah. There are 11 different amp models on the amplifier as well.
Yeah, with a little quick click wheel, as you can see on the top there.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's packed full of features.
Yeah.
The other good thing about this is that it's got something called bass reflex design, which is a proprietary design to the cab, which basically gives you the most low-end response that they can design within a combo cab like that. You've got built-in tuner, you've got a headphone in, and you've got an aux in as well, so that you can plug in your iPhone and then your headphones and then jam along quietly.
And another cool thing that I just remembered is that if you are using the editor on your computer or whatever, you can get some signature sounds of cool guitar players, famous guitar players as well. But again, we've made our own sounds. Just, you know, we've been dialing in what we liked, and then this is what you're going to hear now.
Thank you.
Alrighty. Well, there you have the three tones. So we made these tones again. So clean, a little bit of dirty, mm-hmm. and some little bit of rocky, and two different guitars. And I think we just need to move on to the next amp.
Let's do it.
So I don't know which one we're going to pick because there are seven of them. So let's just click our fingers and find out.
Next on our merry list of modeling amps that we're going to be shooting out today is the awesome Marshall Code.
Code, Bletchley.
Yes.
The
it
Code
is.
Machine.
It
the
is.
Enigma Code Machine. I think that's where they got it from.
Okay.
Yeah, look that up.
Interesting.
Something Wilson Keane, Bletchley, where they make that. The Code Machine, Enigma Code.
There you go. A bit of insight
anyway,
for you.
I think that's where the name comes from.
So the Marshall Code was released at NAMM in 2016.
NAMM.
And it's essentially Marshall's version of a modeling amplifier.
Yeah.
So what they've done is they've developed all their models with the company SoftTube. So they've done stuff like JVM, JMP, JTM, JCM800.
Yeah. American AB, you know, there's just loads of different tones in there. And you control it all from this very, very easy to use app.
Mm-hmm.
So you basically turn this on, you've got your presets in here, and you can store all your own presets. I'm just going to give you a quick, it's very easy, you literally just Bluetooth up. You go in here, you choose all your amps in here, you click in here, you get your JTM45, we'll get some more screen set. You just scroll, you can get your preamp, your amp, you can choose your cabinets, and they got loads of different cabinets, very easy. You can do your effects in here, you can get overdrive, you get modulation, as all the other ones, reverb, spring, all of this stuff. You basically, when you go into your effects, you go into that, you click that, and then you choose all your different whole spring, room, reverb, whatever, and you turn it up and down here. Like, I don't know if you can see that cool little thing. And then you got your playback. You can get your iTunes library in here to play along to. And then you've got your menu, you've got your tuner, you've got your connection, all of that stuff. So very easy. But we've, again, made our own sounds already, so we're not going to use that now. That was just a quick run over of that quick app.
So Marshall Code also comes with 24 built-in effects.
Yeah.
So you've got everything from your dynamic effects like compressors and noise gates all the way through to your modulation, phaser, flanger, tremolo. It also comes with a foot switch, which you can buy separately if you wish.
Which is on screen now, I believe, right there. And it comes in different configurations. The one we have here is the 50 watt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So there's loads of stuff in the range that will be below in the description box. It's very, very light. I think this is the lightest one of all of them. I think it's 13 kilos. It's one of those.
Wow.
It's like a shoebox.
Yeah.
You're like, hey! When you lift it up, you go, oh my God, it's so light. You know,
yeah.
You think,
what is that? Easy to gig with.
Yeah, exactly. And I think I think you can gig it. It's pretty loud.
It's a nice size box as well. Good for bass. Yeah, good for bass response.
Nice size box.
Mm. Thank you.
All right, guys, so there we have it. That was the Marshall Code 50. And again, they do a whole range. Have a look at the links below. My good Lord, that was loud.
It was indeed.
That was very loud. My ears are actually ringing. But so that goes to show a 50-watt amp is loud. It's yeah. loud in this room. Anyway, let's see what happens next. Let me put my pick in my mouth and eat it, because that's what I do with picks. And then let's snap our fingers and go to the next.
All righty.
Hey!
Hello.
Back in the room with the Mustang. Or in a room with a Mustang. So that's yeah. that side. Fender McCutcheon cover.
Yeah,
exactly.
Fender Mustang. This is 100 watts.
100 watts.
It's got a 12-inch Celestion speaker in it.
It does.
It's got loads of different features, yeah. as all these modeling amps seem to do these days. This one in particular has 17 different amp models that you can choose from. We've got built-in effects, reverbs, delays, tremolos, flangers, exactly. all the rest of it.
Yeah. USB connection, you can take out, you can use, put it straight onto your laptop. It comes with this, it's an Ableton, what do we call it?
Ableton, yeah.
Ableton Live, the Defender, you get a studio edition pack for them. Mm-hmm. It's got XLR, DI out on the back.
Left and right stereo,
it's got an effects loop.
And as we said before, the reason that we've chosen, for the most part, the 112 combos is because they're most likely to be a decent enough wattage that you can gig with, but also they feature all the main features that you'll find on the bigger and, you know, some smaller versions. So we're going for the halfway house model of the ranges, you know, just
exactly.
to recap.
Okay, so on the front there, you can see there's a little cool display, there's a little LED display or something there, and there's some switches there. There's a big knob which you can scroll to the things. It's got a phone out, it's got an aux, it's got that USB, and it looks really cool, an input. And I think we just need to hear what it sounds like.
Can you clean it up for us, Pete?
I can clean it up for you. So again, we've just done a clean tone. I think this one is kind of a deluxe kind of thing with a 60s reverb. So you can choose from Fender's back catalog of amplifiers. You can choose their reverb from this amp or from that amp, and you can choose, you know, that one. And of course, it's got loads of high gain stuff as well in there. So, but this is our clean tone, and it sounds something like this. Thank you. Alright guys, so there we have it. That was the Fender Mustang 3 version 2 and 100 watts, and that was loud.
That was pretty pokey.
You might be able to see on our faces there, and it's really loud. And I thought there was some really good tones in here. Nice clean tones, nice reverb tones, we, you know, and again, come and try them out because you need to, if you want to try the delays and the reverbs and, you know, flanger, phaser.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's just it. Tremolo. We're dialing in our tones in the room, you know, exactly. It sounds really nice to us in here. So hopefully you're getting the same thing in your end.
We're not using presets.
No, we're not. We're all dialing in our tones completely from scratch.
Exactly. See the links for the prices because they might change. Mm-hmm. They're up and down. Anyway, let's move on to the next amp, shall we?
Yep.
Okay, let's do it.
And we're back in the room.
Back in the room.
Back with the Boss Katana. So this is a recent amplifier released by Boss themselves, and it's really cool.
It's very cool.
It's a modeling amplifier. It comes in a range of different sizes. Yep. And the cool thing about this is it's kind of a more modern take on the old the Cube series.
Yeah.
So you've got like an acoustic amp, you've got a clean, you've got a brick crunch, you've got a lead and like a brown sound kind of.
All in one sort of simple knob. I'll say this is probably the simplest, the simplest of the amps that we've got, you know, where you say, okay, we'll just do bass, middle, treble, presence, and then five different settings. But you can, if you want to, you know, you can, there is an editor where you hook it up to your, you know, your computer or whatever with the USB. And then you can do loads of different settings. You know you get some presets in here. There's 3-4 presets, and then you can choose all the Boss amp pedals, all of that stuff. It's set up in a certain way, and you can change that with the editor.
Yeah.
But I think what they're going for here is just making it as simple as possible. Plug it in, turn it up, and then you know see what you go for. It's got a really cool power scale feature as well.
Yeah. And the good thing is that the effects that are in the amplifier are sort of based on the Boss stomp boxes, so you get the same quality effect that you would in the stomp boxes built into the amplifier. So that's a good plus.
Yeah. So anyway, so
we're going to give you some tones.
We're going to give some tones. So we dial in the first clean tone as we are, and I'm again using the Fender Mexican Stratocaster. I like this guitar.
It's a nice guitar.
It's a nice guitar. For about 500 quid. In November 2016.
There you go.
Yeah. Thank you. So there we go, that was the katana.
Sliced right through that one.
It slashed right through that one, hey, because katana means, of course, a samurai sword.
It does indeed.
It is like
an incredibly sharp and dangerous sword.
Yeah, and it's like a code as well or something. Mm. I don't know, maybe we could look that up and put it on the in the description, or maybe you can just Google it. Google is your friend.
Yeah. Or maybe we should move on to the next amplifier.
Maybe we should do that. Katana 100 from Boss. Next one coming up now.
We got a new amplifier sat between us, and that is the Blackstar ID60 TVP, which stands for True Valve Power.
True Valve Power?
It does indeed.
Okay, well there we go. There's no valves in there.
No, there's no valves in there.
This is so clever. These boys are so clever. Boys and girls.
But it's all that emulation modeling valve, you know, tone. And these amps have been around for quite a while. My dad actually owns the 30 watt version of this.
Oh, there you are then.
And he loves it. It's essentially, you can select between loads of different power amp tubes.
Yeah.
So you can do EL84s, 34s, 6L6s, 6V6s, KT88s.
EL84s.
And you can do KT66.
KT88? Yeah. Did you say that? He probably said that.
I did say that.
Yeah, he did say
There's a lot of different valves going on. You've also got your effects.
Oh, your effects over there?
Yeah. So you got your reverbs, you know, delays.
There is a lot in there. There is a lot in there. And it all you know, you've got your infinity shape function.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Again, like Blackstar or something. Mega useful. Mm-hmm. You've got on the front here a little bit like the katana ramp. You've got a clean, warm, clean, bright, crunch, super crunch, OD1, OD2.
The cool thing about the ID stuff is, as well, you can buy the optional foot switch upgrade as well, which allows you to control the amp and create presets and bank up and bank down, all that kind of stuff. It's a separate purchase, but it is optional, so it is there for you if you want it. We'll put that in the description box as well.
And there's outputs in the back of this one for line out and all that stuff, and inputs for your MP3 player and so on and so forth.
Yep.
Get a single 12 in here. 60 watts. Clean tone sounds like so.
Yes, mate.
Is that all right?
We'll be right back.
Okay, guys, so there we have it. That was the Blackstar ID60.
TVP. True valve
power. And we're going to move on now to another Blackstar because, you know, we are a Blackstar now. Now we're not going to snap our fingers. Well, maybe we are. I don't know. Anyway, let's move on to the next amp.
Okay, so we're back. We've got a new amplifier sat in between us.
Oh, yeah.
This is the Blackstar ID Core. This is the 100 watt 210 combo.
210. So the reason why is 210 is in there, not a 12, is because this has got the wide stereo effect done.
Yes.
In there.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
This is a bit of a different amp to the others that we've been listening to so far. Because now we're starting to get into the stereo territory.
It's really quite cool because obviously it features a lot of the same sort of ideas as the ID Core, for example. However, with the 210, you've got stereo delays, ping pong delays, stereo reverb, well, all the ping effects pong. Are stereo. So it's really, really quite good. You've also got built-in looper.
Yeah, so you also get the foot switch, of course, where you can control all that from. So the looper, you've got the FS12, which is a five, it's got five knobs on it. And then you've got, you can expand that with another.
Nice.
Foot switch, FS13.
Right, okay.
It's called. You put on the other end there.
So you can build onto it.
Yeah, you got, you know, you got tuner built in. It's very much as you said, as the TVP, the other Blackstar, got all the built-in effects as well. It's got the IFS switch.
Yep.
But as this is a true stereo amp, we've set it up with two microphones. So we'll try to see if we can get in our clean tone some like stereo reverb and maybe a little bit of stereo delay for you.
Yes, you can also edit it with USB. It's got an MP3 in so that you can listen to your favorite songs through the speakers.
Effects loop.
Yep. With regards to the voicings, they're very, very similar to the ID60 TVP. So you've obviously got your clean, your crunches, crunch two, OD1 and OD2. So it's all the same sort of stuff.
Yep.
The ID Core also has its own app, which you can use to edit the amp and create your presets and stuff called Insider. We've got 12 built-in effects and a built-in tuner. And when you eventually get Insider, you can store up to 36 patches. So that's absolutely awesome.
Thank you. right then, that was the ID Core Wide Stereo. I hope you heard some of that stereo effects that we hear in the room. That, of course, is very difficult because we are trying to mic it up and you have to come in and plug it in and then experience the ping pong delays and all the effects and the modulation and all that stuff. Yeah. Shall we move on to the next amp?
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's do it. Yeah!
We've returned.
There is a spider over there! No, there's not a spider, there's a spider there.
Oh, right.
Gotcha!
I was looking as well, like...
Looking at the spider, I don't like spiders. Well, I'm gonna like this spider.
I'm not a huge fan of spiders, but this one, different story.
This one is a different story, because this is line six, new spider fünf.
Yeah.
Fem.
Spider five.
In Danish, yeah. And this is the 60 watt. So this one is the 60 watt with a 10 inch speaker.
Yep.
But it is a full range.
Yes, it is.
So an FRF, is that what they call it?
Yes, which means you have a separate tweeter.
Exactly. Yeah. So that's why you might look at it and go, oh, that's mic'd up a bit weird.
Yeah.
But that's because we're trying to capture the speaker and the tweeter so you get the full range effect. Because it is, this amp is probably the most, with the most features of all of the ones we looked at today.
Full.
It is packed full of features. Yeah. So it's like drum machines, backing tracks, and you know, and looping, and you know, can even we got this thing here, which is the
huge foot controller.
Exactly, FPV 3. You know, where you got the wah and all, it's really cool when you when you do the editing and stuff, which you're doing via a piece of software on your iOS device.
It means you can program the entire board to run with the amp.
And all the colors and all that stuff, you know, it's really, really clever. There's a lot and a lot and a lot and a lot of features in this.
Yeah.
And it's a big range as well. Unfortunately, we couldn't get the 12. It's still so new that's not there. But when it comes out, you can always come in and try it out in the shop.
Yes, it's worth saying that the bigger amps in the range have XLR left and right out on the back, so you can get a line out if you want to go straight in.
Yeah.
If you don't have the luxury of microphones or an expert that can mic up, you know, the driver and the tweeter separately.
Yeah.
So that's something to bear in mind.
It does have this.
Yes, that is very cool.
This is so cool. And if I do this and I go play, unplug it, nothing.
Wow.
And this little thing is the Relay 10. So this is the wireless. This amp has built-in wireless. You can use it with a cable, of course. But the cool thing is, if you have this in your house, you just sit on the sofa.
Just wander around.
And you
wherever.
Wander around. And you know how you charge this thing?
There you go. Crazy technology.
Totally cray cray. And how it's all controlled is via the iPad. And you might see, I'm just going to try to see if I can set myself back a little bit, because you have to have this plugged in with a cable. I'm just going to quickly show you how it is. So easy. I've chosen an amp here. So you click the amp. You get all the settings, preset volume. Can you see this all right in the camera? Good. And then you double click on that. Then you get all of your... I've also chosen American amp. So you get your 60 Super O.
You get
your
nice little pictures
tone,
as well.
Two-tone little pictures. You get your matchless. You get your Buddha. You get... Look, all of these, look.
Oh, they've just and then you go
back,
so much
and then
stuff.
You go back to type,
yeah,
to the block types, and then you've got your cleans, you got your American, you got your British, you got your
high gain
amps,
yeah,
and then you pick one, go done, and then that's it. You can choose your cabinets, where the microphone is set, which microphone it is, early reflect, all this sort of stuff.
That you compressors. Can just create your own signal path, you know?
Yeah,
really cool.
And all of that can be then, you know, you can choose all your drives, dynamics, delays. They've got all this funky coloring going on.
But in this video, we're doing a clean tone, we're doing a crunch tone, and then a high gain
tone.
So it's going to be a little more simple than a full in-depth review.
Exactly. So here we go. This is our clean tone that we made earlier. Sounds like this. So guys, there we go. That was the Line 6 Spider 5 with the amazing little relay.
That is very cool.
That's very cool, isn't it? Let me just charge it up for next time.
Yeah, I know. Oh,
how cool is that?
Yeah.
That's very, very cool, isn't it? That's very cool.
I also liked how quick and easy it was to just mess around and save settings and change stuff.
It's very, very easy. It's very quick. Yeah. It's very easy. You can play, remember, you can play music on this. It's got drum loops. It's got all that different stuff. You can play along to it. And it's a very complex amplifier, the most complex.
Yeah, there's a lot of features packed into the amplifier.
Most features of all of the ones we've had today. So we literally looked at from very simple up to, anyway.
So there you go. That would be the Line 6 Spider 560.
All right. Well, that was some video, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And we've unplugged them all and we put them all back up.
We have. Yes, it's been one of the most intense videos I think I've ever shot in store. It's taken us an entire day.
Yeah.
and a lot of coffee.
Yeah.
But I think it's fair to say that there's a lot to be said for the whole sort of affordable modeling amp market, because they all do something incredibly well that the others don't.
Exactly. There's something for everybody. Like the Line 6 has got all the built-in drums and band you can play along, and it's got the wireless thing. Mm. The Katana is very, very, very simply laid out, and you can just plug it in.
It's nice and concise, well-tuned.
Exactly.
The Valvetronics has got the 12AX7 preamp that actually allows you to actively change the bias in real time, stuff like that.
Stereo for the ID core.
Yeah.
This is very traditional tones in here with a cool little display on
Lovely Fender cleans in it.
Exactly. The Marshall is really cool with the app and all that sort of stuff. And it's got all those Marshall-y tones.
The classic amps.
And all the cabinets, exactly. All the stuff that you want from a Marshall.
Yep.
The Blackstar.
And the TVP.
It's just great because also that's
really
good simple. That's a really good sound. And loads and loads of features, and it is just a matter of you coming in to try them out.
There's a million and one features in each of these amps. So
It's literally what do you need?
Yeah, this isn't us saying what we think is best. This is literally us giving you the opportunity to decide for yourself.
Yeah, what do you need? Do you need a looper? Do you need a looper? Do you need to be able to play Bluetooth music to your thing? Yeah. Do you need to have wireless to walk around your house while you're jamming out in front of your cat? Or do you need all this stuff? What do you need?
Who knows?
Who knows? We don't know.
No.
You're the only one that knows what you need.
Well, look, if there's anything you want to find out about these amplifiers or anything else about the range, that we've
got
all that information, the pricing for everything in the description box below.
Because prices change that we know at the moment, being a lot of things happening.
Indeed, out there in the financial climate of 2016.
Out there in the world. Out there in the world.
Mm.
So I think we just need to say our adios.
Indeed we do. My name is Rabir.
And I'm Pete, and we will see you very soon, because I'm sure we will have another Shootout video in the future.
Yes, we will.
Do you think?
I'd love to.
Yeah. So actually, let us know what you think we should do.
Yeah, any more Shootout ideas?
And this is an epic one, and if we can do anything, if we can do this, we can do anything.
Yes, we can.
Exactly. Take care, guys. See you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Something else to add to the ID core is there's 12 different effects that you can use. There's a built-in tuner. And if you are lucky enough to get Insider, you can store 36 different patches. Something else pretty cool about the ID core is there's 12 built-in effects. Oh no. Oh. Okay. Something else really good about the ID Core is we've got 12 different. Oh, now you're starting. Look, we are nearly done.
Yeah, we need to get this done.
Okay. Something else that's great about the ID Core is we have 12 built-in effects. Oh my God. Another great feature on the Blackstar ID Core is we have 12 built-in effects and there's a built-in tuner. And when you get inside it, you can also... Oh, we've got to just get this line out and then we can move on. Another great feature on the Blackstar ID Core is we've got 12 different effects and there's a built-in tuner. And when you eventually get inside it, you can also... Another great feature on the Blackstar ID Core is the 12 effects built into the amplifier. We've also got a built-in tuner.
Stop going for your coffee.
No, I can't. I'm trying to cover my face up with
okay.